Welcome to Strength of Materials, Simple Stress and Strain, the numerical going on for the videos. In this video, some more numericals related to composite sections and composite bars are there. So let us see, this is the particular figure and the numerical question is like this. Three equally spaced rods, equally spaced, we can see the equal spaces between the rods as the particular small a, it is able to see to us. In the same vertical plane, support a rigid bar AB. This is a support a rigid bar AB. Two outer rods are of a brass. Two outer rods are of a brass. Each is 600 mm long and 25 mm diameter. Also in the figure, it is given 600 mm long and 25 mm diameter. The central rod is of a steel that is 800 mm long and 30 mm in diameter. So determine the force in the rods due to an applied load of 120 kN through the midpoint of the bar. Through the midpoint of the bar, there is a load which is acting 120 kN. Clear? So how much is the force in the rods due to this particular load we have to determine. So a bar remains horizontal after the application of load, means there we have to see that this will not have any undulations, or it may come in this side or it may come in this side. So that is the equal elongation will take place into the two brass rods and in the steel rods. So the particular bar remains horizontal after the application of load. Okay, so they are mentioning us to take ES upon EB as 2. ES upon EB, that is Young's modulus of steel divided by Young's modulus of brass is equals to 2, they are going to say. So let us see, given ES upon EB is equals to 2, and now strain in steel and is equals to strain in brass, directly coming for the solution, so that is not much difficult for us. Now strain in the steel and strain in brass, as I have said that in previous video, how we are able to come to this particular conclusions. So that is sigma S upon E and sigma B upon sigma B. So we know that what is strain in the particular part, that is E small e is equals to sigma divided by capital E is the strain what we are able to see. So substituting that value, strain, that is sigma S is P upon A into L. If we take it to change into length, now if we are able to see the change in length, so change in length is nothing but we are getting multiplied by the length here. So this is particular P into PS into LS divided by AS into ES is equals to PB into LB divided by AB into EB. This is change in length of formula. So now equating this, we will be cross multiplying and checking. So we can see there PB is equals to LS upon LB multiplied by EB divided by ES, into bracket the area formula gets turned. So that is AB is pi by 4 dB square and divided by pi by 4 ds square. So square together I have taken in this part. Now we can see this square is here, so pi by 4 the same part is getting cancelled and ps as it is. So length of steel is 800 mm, length of brass is 600 mm. EB by ES, so we are seeing that ES by EB is given, ES divided by EB is given, that is 2, which is, if I turn out to be it in the opposite direction, that is EB by ES, it will be 1 upon 2. So that is I have what written in the particular equation. So whichever you can find, you can easily find. So 1 by 2, this part I have incorporated here. So 1 by 2. So 25 divided by 30, that is diameter is of the brass is 25 mm and diameter of the steel is 30. Pi by 4 gets cancelled. So 25 by 30 whole square into PS is now the new equation. Now moving further part, the PB is equals to, after calculation we get that PB in terms of PS, that is 0.463 in terms of PS. So load is equals to load, total load is equals to load in steel plus load in brass. We already know this equation also. So P is equals to PS is equals to 2 times PB. So why 2 times? 2 bars are there, 1 bar and the second bar of the brass. So 2 bars are there. So 2 bars will be taking into place. So for that reason, 2 times PB. So it is PS is in steel and 2 times PB is 2 bars of brass. So total load is 120 PS. Now PB will be substituted in terms of PS. So 2 into 0.463 PS we are going to substitute and calculate what is the value of PS. So PS comes out to be 62.3 kilonewtons and similarly PB comes out to be 28.8 kilonewtons. So as per the requirement of the question, we have determined the load taken by the steel and load taken by the brass. So this PB is by each brass rod, it is taking 28.8 kilonewton. Moving to next problem, a round steel rod supported in a recess is surrounded by a coaxial brass tube. Coaxial brass tube means this is the brass tube which is here provided. We can see shown in the figure, the level of the upper end of the rod is 0.8 mm. The level of the upper end of the rod is 0.8 mm below that of the tube. So below that of the tube is the steel tube. This steel is the upper end of the steel tube is below the tube is how much? 0.8 mm this distance. This is 0.8 mm distance. So find out the magnitude of the maximum permissible axial load, how much load we are going to take into place here, how much load it can take, which can apply to be a rigid plate resting on the top of the tube. The permissible values of compressive stresses are 105 MPa for steel and 75 MPa for brass. Okay, the amount by which the tube is shortened by a load if the compressive stresses in the steel and brass are same. If they are same, then what is the amount of tube it can be shortened? So take ES is equals to 210 GPa, EB is equals to 105 GPa. Going further, dia of a rod is given as 20 mm for the particular sections and the particular part. So area of steel, so this part, diameter of the steel rod is, sorry, this is 36. We can see in the figure, all data is given in the figure, nothing is provided in the question. Then we are calculated area of steel, then area of brass is given, that is 60 mm external and 50 mm internal we are able to see. So this, when we calculate, we get this 863.93 mm square. Then same part we are going taking further. So determination of load before the compression of the rod. So before the compression of this rod, what is the load which will be coming on the particular brass rods? So let W be the load applied on the for the initial compression of the tube. So initial compression of the tube will be occurring for this, and once the this load will be coming at this particular level, at particular steel level, let us say at this level. Okay, so it is coming by how much? 0.08 mm of the tube before the compression of the rods starts. So that is delta B is equals to sigma B upon L, that is change, part of change in length. So change in length of the brass is how much? We are already knowing 0.08. what is the stress we are going to find? So stress is this much, that is sigma B into 300 divided by 105 into 10 raised to 3, the E value of that particular brass rod. Therefore sigma B is 28 MPa, that is 28 newton per mm square only. Sigma B, it is a stress, not the load. So therefore load will be what? WB, that is stress into the area. Stress into area, we know that the load is equals to stress multiplied by area is going to give us the particular load. So load comes out to be 24190 newtons. Determination of additional load is how much? So we have to see what is the determination of additional load which will be going for the particular part. Limiting value of stress in the brass is 75 MPa. Limiting value of a stress in the brass, so brass can take up to how much? 75 newton per mm square. Clear? So beyond that, if it is going, it is going to have a failure. So we need to see that it should not pass 75 MPa. So let us see how much maximum value additional can it take. So now it has gone 0.08 mm also down. There we are able to see it is taken 28 Newton per mm square. And remaining as per the question, it is given 75 Newton per mm square. So how much additional it can take? Additional it can take only 47 Newton per mm square. If it exceeds 47 Newton per mm square, then the particular brass tube is going to have a failure. Let W is additional load on the compress both the particular brass parts. Then whatever the W is, it is total, we will see what is the compression is on steel, compression is on brass. Both together will be sharing. Now brass will also be share and steel will also be share. Stress in the steel is sigma S and additional stress in the brass is sigma B. Let us take in the second part. Seeing in this part, now length, change in length of steel is equals to change in length of brass. So that is nothing but whatever, now the particular load is at this place. We need to remember that it is at this place, exactly it is touching to the steel section also, and it is going to come in the downward direction. ES is equals to EB. Now what is the change in length strain? So that is multiplied by L will be there. So sigma S LS divided by ES is equals to sigma B LB divided by EB. Therefore, if I convert it into the terms, sigma S is equals to LB divided by LS is equals to into ES divided by EB multiplied by sigma B, which is equals to substituting the values. The LB is how much? Length of the brass 300 mm. Length of the steel rod is how much? 400 mm. That is 300 mm plus 100 mm, 400 mm. So now taking the particular part, ES, that is 21000 divided by 105000 into sigma B. So it comes out to be sigma S comes out to be 1.5 times sigma B. Sigma S, the stress in the steel is 1.5 times of stress in the brass. Stress induced in the steel rod is sigma S is equals to 1.5 times 47. So what is the additional load we can take? That I have taken as 47 now, which we have calculated, which is by 75 minus 28 we are going to see, then we are able to get in the 47. So that 47 is nothing but we are able to take the additional load. So additional loads 1.5 times we have to consider. It is the total 70.5 Newton per mm square. It is less than the permissible value of stress in the steel. It is very less than the permissible value of stress in the steel, which is 105 as per the given in the question. Thus W, whatever the W we are going to consider, PS into AS, load it is PS into AS plus PB into AB. Substituting the values, PS is what? This particular end, and AS, PB is what? 47. Area of steel is already calculated, area of brass is already calculated. So total load comes out to be 112365 newtons. And now calculating determination of total load, how much is the total load which will be there? Additional load carrying it by steel load was one load. This is the when they are coming into particular section. Now what is the total load it is acting, including all the part? So that total maximum load is this much, 112365 plus 24190 is equals to 136555 newtons. So determination of how much is the shortening of the tube now. So this was already shortened by 0.08 mm and now what is the shortening of delta in the steel, we need to find out. So that is, let delta be the shortening of the steel rod. This will also be the additional part. Additional part, why? Here 0.08 is going down. Below this it is going somewhat. So this part is additional. So this additional, let us take it as delta. And this additional in the brass is same as normal change in the length of steel. We need to check this part. So need to understand the problem very carefully. Shortening of the brass tube. Delta B plus delta is equals to sigma B LB divided by EB. Similarly, sigma B is what we will find, that we are taking into place the particular section. We are changing this part. So this is the what changes we are going to do is we will be just replacing these sections. So sigma b to be determined, I'll take it this on the side and lb on the side, so it will be like this: sigma b is equals to eb divided by lb multiplied by delta b plus delta. So this is in this format, this particular format, eb divided by lb delta b into delta. Now what is sigma s? And sigma s is also there, that is eb divided by es divided by ls into delta. This is in the brass, this is not in the brass. Delta is only here, and in brass 0.08 plus delta. Okay, so 0.08 is already there. This is in the brass, this is in the steel. So this is for steel. So steel stress I'll write, if I write it in the sigma s, it is es divided by ls into delta. Equating stresses in the steel and brass, we are able to see, then we will get the particular delta value, that is 0.16 mm. So total deformation, total shortening is 0.08 plus 0.164, which is 0.24 mm. Thank you. See you.